Hey students, so now we are going to learn a very interesting concept of Fourier series, which is known as Parseval's identity. Now guys, the thing is, what is the formula of Parseval's identity? So you must have covered this part in electronics, because there is a theorem called as Parseval's theorem. And I have seen many students who learn this theorem in the electronics. So here we are not gonna think it from the electronics point of view. We are gonna consider its formula to solve the Fourier series. So guys, this Parseval's identity, we will derive the formula for that, or I'll write down the formula. And if you want the derivation, you can go through my other videos. So what is the Parseval's identity? So it is given as 1 upon 2L integration C to C plus 2L. So I'm just writing the generalist formula, f of x the whole square dx equal to a naught square plus 1 upon 2 summation n from 1 to infinity a n square plus b n square. So this is called as Parseval's identity. Now guys, if you will see here the range, it is C to C plus 2L. But in the exam, you get a question for range 0 to 2 pi or 0 to 2L or minus pi to pi or minus L to L. So in that case, how this formula changes? So let's see. So let's say if I want to find out the formula for 0 to 2L. So what I'll do is, I will just put C as 0. So this will give me, here I'll write for the interval 0, 2L, we will get Parseval's identity as 1 upon 2L integration 0 to 2L. So what I did here is, I put C as 0. So f of x the whole square dx equal to a naught square plus half summation n from 1 to infinity in bracket a n square plus b n square. So this formula we will use if the given range is 0 to 2L. Now let's say if range is from minus L to L. So guys, again we will have same formula, only the range will change. So for that we will put C as minus L. So this will become negative L, this will become negative L plus 2L, that is positive L, so minus L to L. So same formula is there. Now let's say if I have a range from 0 to 2 pi. So let's see what we get. So for that, in this formula, we are going to put L equal to pi. So this will become 1 upon 2 pi integration from 0 to 2 pi f of x the whole square dx equal to a naught square plus 1 upon 2 summation n from 1 to infinity a n square plus b n square. So this is the formula for 0 to 2 pi of Parseval's identity. Now similarly, if we have negative pi to pi, in that case this range will change, minus pi to pi, and the remaining formula will be same. Now if I want to find out Parseval's identity for half range series, then let's see what we get. So here I'll write down, for half range cosine series. Now let's say if I want to find out the half range cosine series in 0 to L, then that time the formula will be like this: 1 upon L integration 0 to L f of x the whole square dx equal to a naught square plus half summation a n square, because in half range cosine series the value of bn is 0. So guys, you can see here that I have used the range 0 to L. So generally we have the question like 0 to pi or 0 to L. So in that case we just have to change this L, or we have to keep it here pi, and we can use this for half range cosine series. Now let's derive it for half range sine series. So for half range sine series, if we find, then in half range sine series a naught and an are 0, so we will just get bn. So the formula will be 1 upon L integration 0 to L f of x the whole square dx equal to half summation n from 1 to infinity bn square. So guys, this is the formula for Parseval's identity or Parseval's formula for half range sine series. So guys, this is the identity which we are going to use to solve the numericals. Now when do we use this Parseval's identity in Fourier series? So generally in the question, if you are getting the terms in the deduction as a square or raised to 4 or raised to 6, where your original function is, let's say it's just a simple number, let's say 1 upon 2, and in the series you want 1 upon 2 square. So to get that square, we generally use Parseval's identity, because using Parseval's identity we find out the square on both sides. So we get square of function also, and we get square of a naught, an, and bn. So in such cases we use Parseval's identity. So guys, I'm sure that you understood what are the formulae of Parseval's identity in different cases and when to use Parseval's identity. So in the coming examples we are going to use Parseval's identity to solve the numericals and to prove the results. Thank you very much.